It's a multi-billion dollar business transporting dialysis patients to treatment. A government audit found a big chunk of that bill is fraud of patients being transported who lack the medical necessity for going on a stretcher in an ambulance three times a week.
There was some fraud going on there that they probably shouldn't have been committing.
John Bush owns On-Time Medical Transportation in Roselle. He's seen a lot of his competitors, 10 of them, disappear from the marketplace since December. One former worker at a company that went out of business near the end of March says she knew it was coming. She worked in the billing department, and she says she knew the company was not following the rules.
They waited until the 15th of December to start getting all the pre-approvals and all that stuff going. It did take a lot of time, and as we were proceeding through that process, we realized that many of the dialysis patients they were transporting were not supposed to be going by stretcher.
In December, the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services changed the rules, requiring ambulance companies pre-approve a patient's medical necessity for transport.
Almost like a prescription.
The government says prior authorization does not create new clinical documentation requirements. Instead, it requires the same information necessary to support Medicare payments, just earlier in the process.
It was very, very easy to get approval. The only thing you had to worry about was an audit down the road, which many companies didn't worry too much about. I personally did. Fast forward to where we are now, they swung the pendulum much further, where it's very difficult to get medical necessity, almost too difficult. You need to have substantial doctor's notes. They need to be legible.
Bush says despite the extra steps, it's better now because too many competitors did not follow the rules of pre-approval.
Many times when we would say no to a patient because we felt the medical necessity wasn't there, another company would pick up that patient.
Now some patients must wait longer than usual for transport to treatment, or families pay out of pocket in a hope for reimbursement. Bush says his company always had a policy of checks and balances.
We encouraged our EMTs, you know, after they had been transporting, to let us know, you know, if they felt like, you know, maybe something wasn't right.
The government audit found a lot of something wasn't right in New Jersey, South Carolina, and Pennsylvania, such as companies coming on the scene with little experience but collecting millions of dollars per patient in the lucrative business of dialysis transport. But in the quest to rid the industry of fraud and waste, the government has charged some companies and collected millions of dollars in settlements. Michael Hill, NJTV News.